New year, new beginnings. We all like the idea of a fresh start, but sometimes we do end up getting stuck in a rut and our lessons might end up being quite predictable, right? I'm Rubin Zareja, one of your Pavilion EOT vloggers, and in this new series of videos, we'll be looking at different moments in our lessons, thinking about how to make them more effective and, of course, more engaging and fun. And in this video, I'd like to share with you 5 tips on how to start your lessons in a more fun way, engaging students from the get-go. Want to know how? So come with me. It's not uncommon for teachers to start the lesson with some housekeeping and deal with more practical aspects of school administration, such as taking attendance and checking homework, for example. However, with my students, I try to use these initial moments to really set the tone for the rest of the lesson. The first minutes of our lessons can be a great tool to increase learner motivation, deal with challenging groups, or just make the lessons more enjoyable. So let's cut to the chase. Tip number 1, start straight away. Depending on the profile of your students, the first minutes of the lessons can be tricky. Students might be late and start trickling in one at a time, which usually means we have a hard time actually getting started. So we end up facing a dilemma. Do we start the lessons straight away and risk some of the students missing out on important content? It may be counterintuitive, but one of the potential problems of waiting for everyone to arrive to start the lesson is actually to increase tardiness, as the students who are on time end up realizing that it would take a few minutes for the lesson to actually start anyway, and they make less of an effort to be on time the next time. However, if you do use the first minutes of the lesson to do the activities the students enjoy the most, to try new resources and tools, or do activities that are different from what students expect, you'll be sending a clear message that arriving on time is important. Otherwise, students might miss all the fun. Tip number 2, use games to review content. One of the first things that come to mind when we think of fun in the classroom are games, of course. Games and playful activities have been a staple in the English classroom for a long, long time, and they come in all shapes and sizes with a myriad of objectives. You might use the game to introduce the topic and context of the current lesson. A classic example of that, maybe a bit overused, is playing hangman to guess the word that describes the topic of the lesson. But games can also be valuable tools to recap and revise some of the target language, grammar, and vocabulary from the previous lessons, and they can provide a great warm-up. By challenging students with playful tests on what they learned in previous lessons, we're encouraging retrieval practice. In a very interesting post for ET Professional, Michelle Iocristiano tells us a little bit more about it. According to her, studies have shown that retrieving certain information from memory can increase the long-term learning of that specific piece of information. This phenomenon is called the testing effect and refers to the importance of repeatedly testing content so that it can be efficiently stored in memory, which is likely to facilitate its later recall and application. Some online games like Kahoot are extremely popular with English teachers all over the world. Other platforms like Whisk Online also allow you to create your online games for free. One of my favorite features of these two platforms is the fact that you can share the game you created and search for ready games designed by fellow teachers, which helps save a lot of preparation time. Tip number 3, get students talking from the start. In your training as a teacher, you have probably been told that we start lessons with a lead-in, right? This is the stage in which we introduce the topic of the lesson or the subject around which the lesson will revolve. Some common techniques teachers use are showing pictures and asking students to predict what the topic will be, sharing an anecdote about the teacher's own experiences, or asking questions about the topic to different students. Those are all appropriate lead-in options, of course, but they tend to be a bit teacher-centered. Promoting student-student interaction right off the bat can help engage students more. This can be achieved by offering a series of questions on the topic for students to discuss in small groups, or proposing a task that involves negotiation among students, for example. Here are some advantages of having small group work or discussions as a lead-in. It helps students to switch to English mode, it encourages personalization of the topic, it fosters collaboration and group integration, it allows us to diagnose students' current knowledge and familiarity with the topic, and latecomers can be welcomed and put in the picture more easily. Tip number 4, let students do their thing. If you work teaching groups, you've probably noticed how teaching a group that has fun together is much easier than teaching a group where students don't have a real connection or don't get along well. We always try to create a positive environment and establish rapport with the students. But it is not enough to just build rapport with the learners. We also need to build rapport among them. And nothing does that as well as spontaneous interaction. The initial moments of the lesson can be ideal for team-building activities and conversations. You can just let students do their thing and talk a little bit about how their weekend went. According to my fellow Pavilion ERT blogger Chiara Bruzzano, giving students some free interactional space can benefit them and us. Research shows that by interacting spontaneously, students produce longer, more complex utterances and can be motivated to complete their thoughts because of a real need to express themselves fully. Spontaneity helps bridge the gap between inside and outside the classroom. It can make the teacher aware of a myriad of issues that students might be going through. We work so hard to create activities and plan lessons that we might end up taking it a bit too seriously and focusing so much on efficacy that we forget the humans we are teaching. Remember to talk to students, get to know them, and let students get to know each other as well. Lessons can be a lot more fun when we care about the people around us. Tip number 5, don't spoil the surprise. Unlike the previous tips, this one is about what not to do rather than what to do. I have to confess though that this is just a pet peeve of mine, not really something serious or detrimental to students. Don't start the lesson by telling students that today they will have a listening lesson, a grammar lesson, etc. Mind you, making students aware of the aims of the lesson can help increase motivation and make the lesson itself more relevant. Take a look at what is described as the need to know, one of the principles of andragogy, the theory of adult learning and education. Adults need to know why they need to learn something before undertaking to learn it. When adults undertake to learn something on their own, they will invest considerable energy in probing into the benefits they will gain from learning it and the negative consequences of not learning it. However, most adult students do not see the relevance of lessons if you tell them they will learn the present perfect or the third conditional. On the other hand, they are more likely to understand the importance of knowing how to describe past experiences or regrets, concepts that are more tangible to them. In a similar manner, telling students that they will practice listening can be too vague and not really interesting. But telling them that after today's lesson they will be better at understanding news in English can be way more motivating. I hope these tips inspire you to take advantage of the initial stages of the lesson to engage students and make your lessons more effective. But I'd love to hear from you. How do you start your lessons? Do you have any icebreakers you like to use? Sound off in the comments below. And you can also contact me on all social media at whatisELT. Keep learning and keep teaching.